Hello friends, welcome back to my channel DS Tech Mirror. So this is part 3 of my series Learn How to Create Canvas App with SharePoint from Scratch. Before this video, there is part 1 and part 2 for this video. Link for those videos you can find in the description box below. Before watching this video, I will recommend you to watch part 1 and part 2 to get a better understanding. So at the end of the part 2, I told you that in part 3 we will be implementing the admin functionality of the help desk support app, which is in progress till now. So in today's video, we will be implementing the admin functionality. So till part 1 and part 2, we have implemented these many features of the Power App. We have seen the usage of screen, we have developed blank screen, as well as we have seen different templates of the screen. We have used image control, we have used rectangle, we saw like how we can use rectangle to create the headers, how we can use rectangle to implement the blur effect and other usage. We saw the usage of the buttons, we saw what we can do on button clicks, we saw the usage of labels, we saw the usage of the icons, different icons which Power Apps by default provide us. We saw how we can in the left navigation we have all the controls, so how we can group related control together. Then we saw we have galleries, and with gallery we have various template for the gallery also. We saw how we can attach our gallery to our database, and then we can show our data in that. Then we saw like in Power App there are more than 200 connectors, so how we can connect to SharePoint. Then we saw how to read item from SharePoint. We saw like on a click of button how we can remove item from my Canvas app, which in return will delete the item from my SharePoint list item. We saw the usage of the variables in Power App. In Power App, we have global variable, context variable, and the collection. So till now, we saw global variable. Today, we will see the collection also. Then we saw this back function. With the help of this, we can move to various screens. Also, to move between the screens, we have navigate function, which I think we have not added it, but now I will add it in this list. We use navigate to move from one screen to another in my Canvas app. Then we saw form. By default we have new form, edit form, and the view form. So we saw like how to change the form mode, because in the ribbon we have only edit form and the view form. So I can add the edit form, and from the properties I can change it to new form. We saw how to submit the form, that I will on a custom button, like I will add a button and then submit form function is there. I can use that. Reset form is there. How to filter the result which we are getting from the database, and what is the use of first operator. So all these things we have covered till now. Before starting with the admin functionality, I will add the navigate function also. Navigate function is used to navigate between screen. So now directly I will start with the admin functionality. So guys, this is my button, login as admin. So to start with the admin functionality, first of all I will create a collection. See how to use collection. So we will create a collection to store our admin. So what I will do, this I will do at the app level, that is on start, when my app will start. So this is collect. What it will do, there are two collections, that is collect and clear collect. Clear collect, what it will do, it will clear my collection and then it will add it to the collection every time. I don't need to clear my collection manually. So I will select the clear collection. Now I have to name my collection, that is I will name admin list, and now I have to store the values in it. So I will store my email ID in it. So for now I am the admin. So this is my collection. The name of the collection is admin list, and I am storing in it. Another important thing over here, now to know whether the current logged in user is admin or not, I need to fetch the email ID of the current logged in user, since because in this collection I have stored the email ID and I will compare it with this ID. So for that I need connector. I need to connect to a connector. So what I will do, I'll go to the data sources. Till now we have this in our collection, so you can see this admin list collection is also reflecting in my app. So I will go to the connectors. So in the connectors I will connect to Office 365 users. So to get the details about the current logged in user, we have to connect to the connector Office 365 users, and then Office 365 users. So I have to select this one, Office 365 users. So with the help of this I will get the current logged in user. Now I will go to the app level, and over here what I will do, I will store my email ID. To set my email, Office 365 users, Office 365 users. So now it is giving me all these options, direct report is manager. If I want any properties of the current logged in user, I can fetch it with the help of this connector. So I want my profile, so I'll use my profile dot email. So dot mail. So why I'm doing this is, now in my app, wherever I have to use my email, I do not have to type the entire thing. So what I will be doing, I have evaluated my email at the start of the app, and now I will be using this variable my email. I told you in my previous series, that is part 1 and part 2, that using set we initiate a global variable, that is, this is my global variable, and I can use it throughout my app. Now let's go to this button, login as admin. Now we will see whether the current logged in user is admin or not. So for that I will use if condition, but before that let's update our list. So what we have used: Office 365 users, connectors, and the clear collect. Now this is my button, login as admin. I will select this button. On select, I will use now if. Now my email means email of the current logged in user. If my email is present in, I'll use the in operator, where in the admin list. So if my email is present in admin list, so now after comma, first will be my true condition, you can see at the top, and second will be the false condition. If it is true, then set another variable is admin comma true. This is boolean. Otherwise, set is admin comma false. So now what we are doing in this, if the current user is present in the list, so is admin is true, otherwise it is false. Now next is, again we will use two if condition. If my email in which admin list which we have created, it's a collection which we have created at the app level, set, if it is there in the list, navigate, because we have to navigate the admin to which screen. Next screen is the my ticket screen comma screen transition dot none. If I am the admin, I should be navigated, or yeah. And then for the else part, I will implement it. For the else part, we will show user an error message. For that, I will display one error message over here, and I will show that message based on the value, based on whether the current user is present in the admin list or not. So first of all, save it with the error only. We will rectify it, and I will add one label, login screen label. It is at the top. I have already explained you many things about my label. Let's give a message over here: your account is not in admin list, or your account does not have admin privileges will be right. Your account does not have admin rights. I'll increase the font till I'll use the same font, let's say 24. It will be bold and color will be white so that it is visible on this background. Okay, this is good, or this, and then font size will be good. Now it looks good. I will make it center aligned. This is my center aligned. So now it look cool. So now what I'll do, now we have to control the visibility of this label. So what I'll do, I'll go to the visible property of this label. From here, last one is visible. By default it is true. So again I will go back to my this button. If this admin is false, but if this condition is false, that is current logged in user is not present in the admin list, then we should make this error message as visible. So for that I will create another variable, that is set error message comma true. So I think now let's expand it, and then we can see over here. I think I've missed one bracket. So guys, this is my formula. I will explain you again. If you want to put it into a separate line, if you want to move it to a separate line, just shift and enter. So what my first if is doing, if my email is in admin list, set is admin to true, else otherwise set is admin to false. Then if my email is in admin list, if it is true, then move current user to the my ticket screen, otherwise show him an error message. So now what I will do, I will go to my label. This was my label. And I will go to this is visible, and I will make it as, so we can set its visibility based on this variable, that is error message. So now I have implemented the admin functionality for the login screen. So now let's test it. So I will click on play button, and then it is login as admin. Right now I am present in the admin list. So yeah, it is taking me to the next screen, that is my incident. If I want to edit it, so this will remain the same, that admin should be able to edit any incident, admin should be able to assign incident. So if I want to assign an incident to somebody, I should be able to do it, and then I click on update, and then that this incident got assigned. If I click on edit, you can see this incident is assigned, and if I click on cancel, I am back. So now what I'll do, I will remove myself from the admin list. I'll go to the app. This is my control and I will remove my name from this. I will save my Power App. I will now we will test it again. I'll click on F5. So I'll click on login as admin. So you can see this is not working. So the reason is why it is not working, because on app start we are setting this variable. So whenever my app will start, then only my collection will fill this, my collection will get initiated. So right now when my app got started, my collection was having the value, my user, my email address, and according to that I'm still in the admin list. So for what? So to refresh my collection, what I have to do, I have to close this app again and then I will start it, and then at that time this collection will be blank and then only this will work. So for that I will close it. I will publish it and then I will close it. Publishing is not necessary, but it just for my own sake, I published it. It just, I have to close it, leave. And then again, I'll edit now on app start, that collection will get initiated. So this is another important thing which I showed you, that is app on start. And meanwhile, I will update my list. That is, we saw what happens on app on start. We also completed if conditions. In this, so guys, you can see in this series so many important concepts we cover in this three-part series. This is the last video of this series, so let's test it again. I'll click on F5, login as admin. Now it is giving me message, your account does not have admin rights. So my functionality is working perfectly fine. So guys, in this app, the demo which we have started, only one functionality is remaining, that normal user should not be able to edit all the fields. So let's see how we will do it. I will go to my edit incident. You remember we created a variable is admin, so we will use that, and then I'll select the control which I want to disable. Let's say I want to disable assign to, so I'll select that control. I'll go over here and I will select disabled. That is okay. Display mode is there. So I will select my in the edit form, I will select my field assigned to, and in this there is a display mode. So I will use it. So right now it is locked for editing because this is read only. So what you can do, you can simply select it, and from here you can see, you can click on it. It will get unlocked and now you can modify it. So I want to work on this assigned to. And I want to go to edit mode. This is my edit mode for the complete control. Now I will use if condition. So guys, on app start I have created one variable is admin. So if is admin is true, then display mode should be edit. And if it is not true, that is for normal user, it should be view. This it is as simple as that. You can see Power App magic. If we try to achieve this by coding, we need certain lines of code, but in Power App this is just one line, not even complete one line, few words. If is admin, edit, else view. Again, similarly, I'll select another control after assigned to task status. Task status normal user should not be able to do. What I'll do, I'll copy it. I just want to save my time. So this is task status, so that we will also remember, and you can make a note of it what you have learned. This is, you can see it has started reflecting over here. You can see because because it does not have the context of the current item, we have to pass it from the my ticket screen. So those guys who have watched the part 1 and part 2 will be able to understand this. And apart from that, assigned to I have done, task status I have done, priority and percent complete I will do, category disable this control also, and now display mode. So now I think I have completed it. Now let's start with as login. Let's start. By default it should be okay on app start. This will be taken care. So let's start with this login as admin. So I don't have admin right, I will go as user. So guys, we will test with normal user. So I'm able to see the items. Now what I'll do, I'll try to edit it. Now you can see I can't edit percent complete, this is read only for me. Assigned to I can't edit. Priority I can edit. Okay, priority I have not disabled. Task status I have disabled, correct. So if I change the priority to low, because user should be able to do that, and if I click on tick, so the priority got changed. Now what I'll do, I'll close this app. Oh, actually I have to update that admin before, then only I want to close it, but still let's open it again. Let's do one thing, let's not edit it, we will directly open it. So right now what I have to do, I have to go to Power Apps, apps, and then from here I'll click on play, And now my app will start. See how beautiful it is looking. I'll go by login as admin. It is giving me error. Okay, so I go by login as user. Next screen. I want to add an incident. I'll say app play. We are playing with our app. App play. Then category, priority, and then submit. My create item is working. So out of CRUD, C is working, R is working. Update and delete is left. So let's check with the edit. This is low. App play is low. Again, you can check. So this is low. Now my C, R, U is working and I have to check with the delete. So click on delete. Confirmation message. Go back. So for a normal user, my CRUD operation in Canvas app where SharePoint is at the backend is working perfectly. Now I'll go back and I will, what I'll do now, I have to go to the edit mode because I have to update the collection. So guys, for this admin list, you can use a SharePoint also at the backend and you can use filter function for that. Then you don't have to edit your app. You can do it from the SharePoint list only. For now, I want to show you the usage of the collection. That's why I use this approach. Otherwise, you can make an admin list in the SharePoint. You can attach that list to your Power App and then in App Start, you can use filter function. Maybe in separate video, in a small video, I will show you that. But today, I will do it over here. So I will put my name. I will save and close that. Now we'll close that and now we will start our app and we will test for the admin. This is my app name, login as admin. So I'm able to login as admin. Then what I will do, admin can create. So definitely it will work. So let's say admin, because admin is also a user. Admin should be able to, if admin is having any issue, admin should be able to submit its ticket. Then if I want to assign, if I'm the admin, I can assign. Let's assign to DS Tech Mirror this time. Yes, DS Tech Mirror. So this is working. So we saw like other controls which are not working for normal user is working for the admin. If I go to another ticket which are already there, if I click on edit, so yeah, it is in progress. So admin can do that. Admin can delete. So it is working. So app is working. So guys, this is the Power App help desk support which we have created. So this is a 3 video series which we have developed. Before closing this video, I would just like to revise this app for you guys once. What we have in short, I will revise it for you. What I will do, I will see all the concept and I will show you like where we have achieved it and how we have used it. So first one was the screen. So we have created various screens over here in our Power App. You can see login screen and we saw like we have screen, blank screen, other templates. So we used blank screen as well as the other templates. After that we have image. So you saw that inside the screen we have this image, background image, then rectangle. With the help of rectangle we have created various headers over here and also the blur effect for this. Otherwise this image was bit contrasting, little bright for us. So I show you the usage of button. We saw like how to make this button curves from the edges. On select property we show for this button. Labels everywhere we are using. Icons we are using over here in my tickets. Over here I show you how you can use these icons. So by default Power App provides us a rich collection of icons. If you go to your view, if you go to insert icons, you will get all the icons. So you can all these icons. It is a rich set of icons and they are really helpful. After that group, so these were the in my ticket tab, these were the there were controls related to the top header, so I grouped them. So what you need to do, you need to just select your control and click on home and then click on this group. Your controls will get grouped. Gallery is used to view the item. You can attach your gallery to a database. Connect to SharePoint data source, click on this and then connector. You can connect to the data source, SharePoint or Office 365 user. Read item from SharePoint in the gallery, I show you. To remove an item from the SharePoint, this on click of this button, we are moving to a delete screen. And then in delete screen, on click of this button, this is remove help desk. And this is important item to delete. Like from the gallery, we are passing this variable. We are not actually passing the variable. We have stored the pointer to the current item in a variable, and we are using it over there. This is to remove the item set creating global variable. You saw like on even today you saw we have created various variables. Then back, if you go, it just like navigating to the previous screen. Then we saw usage of forms. We have forms in app like edit form. If I go to insert, I can use edit form, display form. So over here in edit, I use this edit form. This is my edit form. Again, I have to attach my edit form to a database. And then for the another important thing is in the item, I filtered it. In the item property of my edit form, what I did, I just stored the current, I just stored the selected item in a variable and I used it over here. So if I go to item, what I did, I just filtered. This is item filter. This is my data source. Filter it. Id equal to item.edit.id. And what is item.edit? This is from my my ticket app. Click on edit. And here I am storing this variable. Set item.edit this item. So this is a small trick over here. Then we saw, yeah, form we have completed. How to change form mode, I show you. Like if you go to this form, from here you can change the default mode, new view, everything you can change. Submit form, you can select this button, and this is the function submit form, and the form name, reset form, same reset form name. Filter, I show you can filter first if you want the first item from a record. Navigate to move between the screen. Office 365 user to get the current user property. Clear collect is a collection. We have created a list of admin list. App on start, like if you want certain variables on app start, you will select your app, and you have on start, you have various on start, size breakpoint, confirm exit message. These are the messages today we used only on start, and then the if conditions we saw. So these many functionality, this is a huge set. This many functionality we covered in this 3-part video series. I hope you like this series. If you find it useful, please like this video and click on the subscribe button below to get the notification for my new video. Till then, much love. Keep learning. Thank you.